Greetings, kids. Bishop Vetter here, your bishop. I'm still your bishop. Good to be with you. I'll read you a book. It's been a little while. This one's called Macaroni and Cheese, Hot Dogs and Peas by Christine Hickson. So let's get started. When I eat dinner, Mom and Dad say, let's thank the Lord for our food today. And I would, but I want to know, please, what does God have to do with my macaroni and cheese? Can I answer that? Can I answer that, please? I'm the macaroni in your macaroni and cheese. I start out growing in a field as wheat. I look like grass, but I'm food to eat. When the wheat grows tall, it grows golden seeds. That's the part of the wheat your macaroni needs. The farmer cuts the wheat and the seeds are ground. Have you ever seen flour? Just take a big mound. Add some egg and salt and water, mix it all up. It's sort of like Play-Doh. You could make a fine bell. But to make macaroni, you need a machine that spurts out noodles. It's something to be seen. It sounds quite exciting, but I'd still like to know, what does God have to do with macaroni dough? Macaroni, macaroni, please don't forget me. When you eat macaroni, it's macaroni and cheese. I also start out as grass growing green, but a cow eats me. It's not as bad as it seems. In the cow, I become milk, all rich and white. But milk isn't cheese. You can't take a bite. Then a farmer milks me straight from the cow. Someone else adds and mixes. Just look at me now. I'm creamy and tasty, wonderful cheese to eat with macaroni, a hot dog, and peas. But you still haven't told me, what does God have to do with macaroni, a hot dog, peas, and you? You haven't heard my story of how I begin. I start out as a pig eating corn in a pen. The butcher then takes me and makes me to be the hot dog so yummy that you love to eat. Stop it. Stop this. You're not helping a bit. No one's answered my question, so I'll keep asking it. Should I thank the wheat, the farmer, or cow? Should I thank the pig or the butcher? Just tell me how. Does God figure into the food that I eat? Why should I thank God before I eat meat? As a pea, I can tell you without any doubt why, when giving thanks, you should not leave God out. God made me at first a little green seed. Then God gave me the sun and the rain that I need. God made the farmer and gave him a love to take care of me like the Father above. He takes care of him and the butcher and all, who takes care of the wheat and cows and pigs in their stalls. Without God, no, not one of us would be on your plate. Thank God for his goodness. It's never too late. Father, I thank you for all that I eat, for the sun and the rain, the seeds and the meat. I thank you especially for hot dogs and peas and my most favorite dish, macaroni and cheese. The end. That's a good book to remind us, huh? To give thanks to God for big things and for the littlest things too. Good to be with you again, kids. Say a prayer for me and know of my prayers for you. God bless. Bye now.